everyone, Andy here, and today I'm excited to talk to you about one of the latest trends in our business, in our industry, which is full format or full frame cameras and lenses coming into the cinema space. I have with me here the Sony Venice, which is their latest line, the flagship cinema camera from Sony, but it's also a full frame camera. It's a camera that has a much larger sensor area than we normally have in cinema. We also have the Arri Alexa LF, which is, again, large format, and the Red Monstro, all large format cameras, and we're seeing more coming soon. And that, of course, means we need large format or full format cinema glasses as well. We'll talk about that, though, at the end. So what I wanted to do is dive into this topic and see why it matters, why it's important to all of us, and what to look for as this trend evolves. First is just a little history. Super 35 is sort of our standard for digital cinema and for cinema acquisition for many years. We've had since Super 35 since the 50s, and that really evolved through the 80s as a standard. This is a much smaller format than you'd find in something like a still camera, which has been full format, full frame for many, many years, pretty standardized there. So why change? Why go there? Well, there's many reasons. So that would be advantageous to go into that. So both some aesthetic change choices, lens choice options, things like that. So let's just dive into a tool that I've made first to help you kind of visualize that difference. I have this a tool that we've created called the Field of View Comparison Tool, which is available here at AbelCine.com/FOV. If you go there, you can see I put in both the Sony F55 as well as the Venice down here. This tool allows you to overlay two different cameras together and select resolutions and compare them. I've chosen these two cameras to visualize a difference between the two. So I'll go ahead and dial in a 35 millimeter lens here. I'll get the idea. And you see I have these two different image areas, the outside being the Venice and the inside being the F55, both in a 17:9 mode, the Venice being in their sort of 6K full format mode, the F55 being in the 4K mode, right? This difference shows you that, you know, at a given focal length, the Venice will give you a wider field of view. That's great. So that's one part of it. But there's more to the aesthetic choice here, which I can show you here in my Final Cut project that I have open. And that comes down to looking at the image beyond just field of view overall. So the first image here is the Super 35 millimeter lens on the Super 35 mode of the Venice, right? So you can see there it is, very nice. And then I cut over to the full frame mode, cropped to 17:9. And you can see, oh, there I got much more image. Great, so gives you wider images. That's sort of understood. Bigger sensor, a lens that covers that, bigger image area. Great. That's great for vistas and a number of different purposes, but it's only one part of the aesthetic reason you might go down this road. The other part is that you match a field of view across, right? The 35 millimeter looks sort of like this on my Venice in the 4K Super 35 mode. If I match an equivalent field of view to it, I get a different sort of look. So what's the equivalent field of view? Well, the tool here has that as well. It says a 35 millimeter lens here equates to around a 52.5 millimeter lens on a Venice in that sort of 6K mode that it's in, 6K full frame mode, cropped full frame mode. So 50 millimeters it is. Back to my project here, you can see, oh, there's the 50 millimeter equivalent, and they're really close field of view wise. You can see just a slight difference between the two, but really they match up just fine. Now what you may have noticed here is that they actually have a different aesthetic. That 50 mil is a longer lens. It has a different look to it than the 35. It's sort of compressed space, and also it's changed just the overall look of the image. And that's the aesthetic choice that comes with this, right? So go back and forth. Look at the area behind Christie's head here, the 35 and the 50. There's a compression that's happening. Things have sort of moved around. And that compression gives a sort of different sense of depth, which many people like that effect. So it's also, when you've done this, reduced the depth of field in the image overall. In the 35, in this setup, I have about a 7 feet depth of field, whereas in the 50, I have about 2 to 3 feet depth of field. So that means I can throw my image way out of focus in the background very easy. ACs don't love this sort of thing, of course, because they got to stay in focus, but that choice is there. Again, versatility and aesthetic choice is the key here. And if I overlay the two, you can sort of see that difference next to each other. It's subtle at this point, but as you get longer, and depending on the setup that you have, you can really see that difference. And it is a big part of the choice. The other big choice that comes along with having a larger sensor in general is the ability to properly use an anamorphic lens. What I mean by proper is that anamorphic was really designed for a 35 millimeter or 4.3 image area for on film. So when we go to a traditional Super 35 lens and put an anamorphic lens on it, the crop kind of gets all out of whack. We end up losing a lot of the image. So for example, if I was going to put a 2x anamorphic on a Super 35 millimeter camera, this is an Ingenue 2X, I get a fairly substantial crop compared to the proper 4.3. So this is the same lens, now no longer cropped in the way that it was because I lost that image area along the way. So having that height of the sensor makes a big difference. Versatility is the key here. So again, just a little aesthetic differentiator. So that's a big deal, of course. Next, of course, is resolution. Resolution isn't tied directly to sensor size. For instance, you have a Red Helium 8K, which is a Super 35 sensor roughly, versus a Red Monstro, which is a full frame, full format sensor size. They're both 8K though, so resolution isn't tied to sensor size, but in the case of something like the Alexa LF, where they wanted to keep that sensor they've had and known for and loved for so long and just add more to it, they now have they've actually just made it larger. So having the same sensor resolution, photo site size, and just added them together means now we can get proper 4K out of that sensor area, which is important for so many. So that's another advantage to sensor size resolution. And then finally, lens choice. Now this is the more complicated issue. Lens choice, for many of us who've purchased Super 35 lenses for so long, is a big concern. Not every lens is designed to cover that larger sensor area. Zeiss has had their line of CPs and CZs for a while. Leica has a new Thalia set, which is amazing and covers even more than full frame. Cook has their S7s. Sigma has their new line of full frame cinema lenses. And of course, there's Canon Cinema Primes and other lenses out there that all cover larger areas. But that lens choice is limited compared to the Super 35 lenses out there. But it's a growing every day. We're going to see more of those. IB has more as it just keeps coming. Back to the FOV tool here. One of the tools I put in here is a tool that helps you throw an image overlay of a basic idea of an image circle from a given lens. We have a little database going, always modifying it, and lets you know, choose a lens, let's say a 24 millimeter ultra prime, and you can see that it kind of vignettes a little bit in the corners of our Venice in this mode. And that's going to happen with some lenses, they're going to vignette. If this happens here in the tool, you got to test it, don't take my word for it. You got to test certain lenses to see if they cover. Usually a longer lens makes a bigger image circle, so always test that. And Arri also has an illumination guide, which they've actually tested many lenses at different sensor sizes, so that's also a good resource. But giving you the idea, there's lenses out there that won't work. So you have to test these things out, make sure they do. But the lenses are coming, the cameras are coming. This is, again, a big trend that you're going to see. So come by our booth at NAB this year. We're going to have a lot of these cameras and lenses there to check out, and we'll be talking more and more about this new trend. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.